When you first start to work in AviPLAN 2025, you'll notice that the service editor has been renamed to configure airplane. Service arrangements are now part of an airplane configuration that also includes the ability to create up to 5 custom airplane labels for each airplane model and to add, customize, and configure service points with new jacking points and tie down points for all airplanes. One of the biggest enhancements we've made in AviPLAN 2025 is the inclusion of pedestal, namely nose loader bridges, as a part of the stand command, which is in your airside and airside pro versions. It's really quite simple, very effective. I hope you're going to enjoy working with nose loader bridges on your next project. Now here's a new feature that I'm sure you're going to find plenty of use for. A user preferences tab has been added to the settings dialog with an airplane labels tab for creating and sharing custom airplane labels. One of the many enhancements we've made to AviPLAN 2025 is the extension of the wingtip clearance surface option so that it extends not only forward of the wings and engines but also around the fuselage. And we'll see how the fuselage is now integrated into the full swept surface option for paths, group paths, and also group lead-ins. We have new functionality to define lead-in line and stop line lengths. We've offered more control over text heights and positioning of lead-in line and stop line labels, and we've improved apron safety line conflict analysis by offering settings per lead-in line. We've made improvements to the element display settings for individual airplanes in a group path, and it's now possible to display airplanes and associated jet blast contours as a group or individual, along with other path elements, down to a per section level. And we're hoping this will give you a lot more opportunities to be able to use this tool